Today we are going to be talking about arousal and performance, and whether it's in a sports setting, playing hockey, basketball, baseball. Ashwin's
tennis?
A big tennis player.
Tennis,
yeah,
yes,
tennis,
yes.
Big tennis player. I used to play a lot of soccer. We all know that arousal can impact us, and many of you might be saying, well, what is arousal? Arousal is simply a measure of kind of our energy level. So it can be really high when we're really excited, can be high when we're really angry and upset. It can be low when we're really tired, like many of you in your 8 o'clock classes when you come and you still need your fifth coffee to wake you up. So arousal is simply a measure of, in general, how excited we are. And we all know that that can impact our performance in sport or even in school. We walk into an exam really nervous, high arousal, we don't perform that well. We walk into an exam really tired, low arousal, we don't perform that well. So what we're going to talk about is a theory today called the inverted U theory, which gives us some information about how arousal can impact our performance.
All right. Now, is it a hypothesis or a theory?
Well, it's a little bit of both. It hypothesizes why arousal can impact our performance, and it's also a theory of what can happen under conditions of high and low arousal levels.
Ooh. All right. So, how many of you get a little bit nervous, all right, prior to a performance or prior to kind of anything? And what this inverted U hypothesis suggests, as Noah's dropping down here. So we've got arousal on the, which axis is that? I always forget.
This would be the x-axis for you math majors.
Yes, x-axis for the arousal.
And I hope.
Yeah, if not, that's just what we're gonna be going with. And then the y-axis for performance.
And on both of these, we can simply measure them from a low to a high. So we have low arousal on this side, high arousal on this side. And again, low arousal, if you think of it almost like a dimmer switch on a light, lights don't just turn on and off. Lights have various levels of brightness, so to speak. So low would be very low, and then high is the very bright dimmer switch. High arousal would be really angry, really energized, really excited. And then we measure our performance from low to high as well. And how the inverted U looks is exactly how it would be described, as an inverted U or an upside down U. So it looks quite simply like this. And Ashwin's going to explain a little bit of how this works.
So we look at it fairly simply as the lower level of arousal that you have, right? You're going to be performing fairly low, right? Your performance isn't going to be very high. However, once your arousal level increases to a certain extent, so too will your performance, but only up to a certain area. Once it kind of reaches its optimal level, then any other increases in arousal level are going to lead to decreases, all right? That is what this suggests, so that eventually your performance just starts dropping off. It's kind of more of a gradual decline.
So we might look at this and say, yes, that makes sense, that I understand that if I show up to a game and I'm not quite ready to perform, many of us have experienced this, maybe the competition's not that great, you're not really that excited, we know that we don't perform that well under low arousal. As our arousal starts to increase, our performance also goes up till we reach this kind of optimal point, beyond which our performance slowly starts to suffer. Now, some of you might be looking at this saying, that makes sense, but there might be some problems. And some of the problems with this inverted U hypothesis or inverted U theory are that it suggests that there's just this one point of optimal arousal, when in reality, as we'll talk about with other theories, there's more likely a range at which you perform at your best. So on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being sleepy and 10 being really, really energized and crazy, where do you perform at your best?
Probably around a 3 or a 4.
Yeah, so there's a 3 or a 4. So rather than just this one point, there's a range. So we'll talk about a theory that addresses that in a little bit. One of the other problems is Ashwin's a 3 or a 4, I'm a 6 or a 7. So this inverted U suggests that we all have this same curve, when in reality, Ashwin's curve might be a little bit more like this, and my curve might be a little bit more like this. That for me, my arousal needs to be over here, Ashwin needs to be over here. So another one of the problems. And then the final problem with this is, if we think about a time where we've been over aroused, over excited, really, really angry, something that Ashwin could relate to as a young tennis player, getting a little bit upset, as calm as he is
just
now,
just a wee bit.
That our performance usually doesn't just slowly, slowly decrease. That there is probably some sort of catastrophic drop-off, which we will talk about as we get to another theory. So this inverted U hypothesis does a very nice job of explaining arousal and performance, but there are some problems with this explanation, which is why we have some more current theories that explain it a little bit better.
All right. So when we come back, we're going to start looking at another theory, which is called the catastrophe theory. All right. That was pretty good.
Yeah.
All right. Nice. Let's do another one. Yeah.